Well, deciding where to eat can be a challenge with countless restaurants here in the Lowcountry.
So Lowcountry's morning meteorologist, our expert on this stuff, Josh Marthers, is checking out locally owned and operated restaurants in a new segment we call Lowcountry Eats.
He's a foodologist.
Mm-hmm. When we decided we were going to start Lowcountry Eats, the first place on my list was Buckshots. This was the first local restaurant I walked into when I moved here almost 10 years ago. So Miriam, a lot of folks pass you by and they don't know what you are. They walk in though and they're in for a treat. Tell us a little bit about what your regulars come in for on a daily basis.
They come in for this fried chicken.
All right, that's your number one deal right there.
That's the number one.
All this other stuff goes along great with it, but the chicken's the big story,
chicken,
right?
Is the biggest seller, and the mac and cheese. If you don't have mac and cheese on that bar, they ask for it. This is a daily item as well, with cabbage. And we don't have shrimp on the bar, but you could order it off the menu.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, the fried chicken is your local's favorite, but it's your favorite too, and it's because you've kind of got an attachment to this chicken, right?
Yes, I did.
All right, what is that?
My grandmother's recipe.
Well, family right there makes
yes.
it all. Now, I know you're not going to share it with us, but you have shared this with somebody, right? Somebody's got this.
Somebody has.
Okay.
But it's in the family.
It's in the family.
Yes.
So I can't have it.
No, you can't.
So I got to get in the family somehow, right?
Yeah. You
So tell us a little bit about your story. How did this place get started? You know, what's the Buckshot story?
My brother had a passion for cooking, and he started cooking out in McClellanville in a little shack. And he came and said that he wanted us to kind of help him spread the word about his cooking.
Okay.
So we all kind of joined in and we created Buckshots. He had a passion for the chicken and we used to do like the fried crabs and stuff like that. But that's how it got started.
Okay, and you guys are open. Are you open every day of the week? Do you take a day off? Do you ever take a break?
We take off Monday.
Tuesday through Sunday, the buffet's open?
Yes.
It's a little something different every day.
Every day. Right? Every day is something different.
Right here in McClellanville on Highway 17. You can't miss it. Little blue house. It feels like home when you walk in.
It is
And
home.
I cannot wait to dig into
it. It is
that.
Home. That's why we have the homey atmosphere.
That's
it
right.
is home. All right.
Yeah, that was...
I can hear the crunch of that
right.
chicken.
It was so good. It was so good. And you know, we had so much to offer up there.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, and the best thing about it is every day there's something a little different. So it's not the same setup every
day. It's
like
being at home.
Yeah, it's you really Moms. Do walk in yeah. in the door and you feel like you're walking into grandma's kitchen. It's
you know,
good
that's
stuff.
My neck of the woods. I'm always at Buckshots. And Josh and I yep. went there when you first came
my
here.
My first trip. and next week we're going to feature the Cuban Gypsy Pantry downtown.
Ooh.
Brand new restaurant. Started out as a food truck. Have a great story and we're going to show you those guys next week.
Yeah.